In this video, I'm going to show you how to find your local SEO competitors on Google Maps. So whether you run a local website or you do local SEO for clients, understanding who your local SEO competitors are can help you find opportunities for content, backlinks, and citations. So if you want to know who your local competitors are, make sure to watch this entire video. And let's get right into the steps.
So your first step is to set up a listing within Semrush's listing management tool. That way, they'll know what your business is, where it's located, and things of that nature for a bunch of different tasks that you can do inside of this feature. But in this video, we're focused on how to find your competitors. And you know, if you're a local business or you're an agency that has a local business client, you probably know some of your major competitors in your space. But when it comes to a local business, you kind of have two different competitors, right? You have your local competitors that are the other businesses in your area, in your block, in your neighborhood that do something similar to you. So in the case of a pizza restaurant, any restaurant in your area is technically a competitor, right? Even if it's Chinese food or Italian or Thai or whatever, they're still technically a competitor because people are choosing between eating at your pizza place and getting Chinese food. And when they search for restaurants in Google Maps, it'll show them everything. So it is important that you have that in mind too, that your competitors aren't just other, you know, similar businesses in your city. They can be businesses that are just, you know, do something similar. It doesn't have to be a one-to-one comparison. So what you want to do is when you set up listing management in Semrush is to first include a keyword that is relatively broad, at least one. So in the case of a pizza restaurant, you'd want to put something like a restaurant. If you rent a pharmacy, you'd want to put something like a pharmacy. You know, keep in mind that some people will search in Google Maps for that broad category, and then some will search for something more specific, and you want both covered. So in the case of the broad keyword, you want to scroll down, hit the heat map button, and then scroll down, and this will show you the results in that area for that specific keyword that you're searching for. That way you can keep in mind some of the competing restaurants that are in your area in this case. And then you want to get some specific keywords as well. So let's look at something like wood-fired pizza. And obviously the results are going to be totally different than they would be for a restaurant. But again, these are competitors that you'd want to jot down and sort of keep an eye on. And once you have this, you can use this to better optimize your own profiles using some things that maybe they're doing. You can look at their reviews in Google Maps and more. But yeah, the main goal of this task is to look at the competitors in the space. And you'll notice an overlap if you go from like wood-fired pizza to brick oven pizza. So the idea is really to get an idea of who you're competing with so you can better optimize your own local SEO. Now, one more tip before we go is if you tracked, you know, let's say 9 keywords or 5 keywords and you have some that you haven't tracked and you're having trouble coming up with them, I recommend using this really nifty ChatGPT feature because it recommends specific keywords that are related and maybe things that you hadn't thought of. So in the case of sort of a higher end pizza place, something like best pizza in town or thin crust pizza would be perfect. Family restaurant is again one of those keywords that you might not think of when you think of your restaurant in terms of a search strategy, but if you do run a family friendly restaurant, that's something people search for on Google Maps and you can get in front of them. So I would track as many as you can, up to 10, inside this feature to make sure you're getting the most coverage possible.
So that's how to find your local SEO competition on Google Maps. And I'll see you in the next video.